Hi, this is Pat Johnson, your sociology instructor, and today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about two competing theories explaining poverty. Now, we can think of lots of reasons why there might be poverty in some countries in the world. There could be a lack of natural resources, there could be natural disasters, there could be war, there could be all sorts of reasons why a country might be poor. In sociology, we have two main competing theories about why there is poverty in some countries in the world and not in others. The first theory that explains why some countries are poor is modernization theory. Modernization theory looks at poverty in some countries as caused by a lack of modernizing. In other words, jumping on the bandwagon of industrialization and using technology to produce more food, to gain specialization, to push the society into the modern era. So, why might some countries not modernize when others have already gone through that process? Well, if you think back to the paper you wrote on the article, The Promise, think about Anafgat's society. They had many cultural practices that did not encourage modernization. For example, education, especially among females, was not something that was emphasized. So what's the role of the wealthy country in relationship to the poor country according to modernization theory? Well, these theorists think that it's the job of the wealthier countries to help poorer countries. For example, they could provide technological aid. They could help the poor countries control population growth. Remember, we found a positive correlation between population growth and the high poverty rates in a country. Another way of saying that would be the lower the income, the higher the number of kids, and that would be a negative correlation. But the rich countries should, according to modernization theory, help the poor countries control their population, help them acquire technology, loan them resources so that they can modernize and move into the future. The competing theory is a social conflict theory, and this theory is dependency theory. And dependency theory doesn't like capitalism. It doesn't want wealthy countries messing in the business of poor countries. And so dependency theory thinks that some countries are poor because they've been exploited either by wealthy countries themselves through colonization. And if you look in your textbook on page 260, you can see a map of Africa. And you can see how many countries in Africa were colonized, and as a result of not so scrupulous political practices, kept the countries poor. The other reason that dependency theory gives for wealthy countries causing poor countries to stay poor is the modern technique of neocolonialism. Now, neocolonialism refers to a multinational corporation going into a country and exploiting the resources. For example, there should be a YouTube link in the general YouTubes for this chapter talking about oil exploration, obtaining oil off the coast of Africa. So companies like Shell Oil will go in, not caring that much about environmentalism and keeping the waters and the countryside healthy, but they'll go in and explore and pump oil and buy it from those countries. And usually there's a lot of corruption where maybe some government officials are gaining, but not the people themselves. And so they will obtain things like oil, and then the country itself doesn't have enough infrastructure to refine the oil, and so the companies will sell gasoline back to the country at inflated prices. So again, dependency theory is all about exploitation of wealthy companies, wealthy countries, and causing just poverty in these countries. So again, this is a social conflict theory. It doesn't like capitalism. It doesn't like poor countries are exploited. So if you see, these two theories, dependency theory and modernization theory, are actually competing theories about why some countries are poor. Modernization theory, again, believes that it's the role of the wealthy country to help the poor countries, and they do this through helping them acquire technology and making them come into the 21st century. And then dependency theory wants wealthy countries to stay away because they cause exploitation of the resources and the people. So think about those two theories. Which one makes more sense to you? Take a look at the additional YouTubes in the link at the bottom of this module and come to your own conclusion.